This period brought to you by Prius V, the newest member of the Prius family with 50% more cargo space.
Glendale, Arizona, where the visiting Vancouver Canucks will have plenty of support in this game as they debut a couple of new faces. Starting goaltender is brought to you by Tim Hortons Premium Blend Coffee, always 20 minutes fresh. Corey Schneider had a shutout in this building back on November 25th, the one and only time he's faced the Coyotes in his NHL career. Mike Smith was quite famously given the game off last time these teams met. He's proceeded to win five more since and is riding a personal 10-game winning streak. Will this be the night Henrik Sedin moves up the Canucks scoring list? He's 1 point behind Trevor Linden for second place all time. Meanwhile, Oliver Ekman-Larsson of the Coyotes hopes to build on his last outing. He had a goal in Edmonton, and that ended a 19-game drought for him. We've got the officials getting over to the Vancouver bench with the lineup card. Now, they announced Chris Tanev as a scratch in the building and had Dale Weiss in the lineup, and you wonder whether there's been a mistake made.
Yes, you wonder on the official lineup card, and you can see Rick Bonus is now talking to the two officials. And now Alain Vigneault steps in.
It's a very important part of the daily routine that sometimes...
Well, and it's checked over. It's not just one coach does it. We've seen it happen where you get the wrong name on it.
They did announce Chris Tanev as a scratch. He's slated to play this game, and he's on the Vancouver bench. And Dale Weiss was not scheduled to play. He's not in uniform. Didn't take the warm-up.
And you can see Dave Tippett looks on. And
he'd love to see the Canucks go with five defensemen.
Yes. Dale Weiss could run down, put his stuff on, and be the 13th forward.
The conversation continues at the Coyotes bench as Chris Lee, the official who was talking to Alain Vigneault, skates over to speak with the off-ice officials, but some early drama. Chris Tanev, he's ready to play. Hopefully they'll let him.
Yes. Trade deadline. Everybody's tired from the trade deadline day yesterday.
It looks like we're sorted out and set to go, and Tanev's going to stay at the Vancouver bench, so all's well that ends well. And underway in the finale of a six-game road trip with the Canucks 3-1-1 and coming off the heartbreaking overtime loss in Dallas. Trying to rebound from that. Here's Edler trying a shot, deflects back to Sammy Salo. Puck was rolling. He dumps it in deep for Alex Burrows. Tried to feed behind the net. Now he gets the puck again. Henrik back to Salo. Long slap shot blocked, and that hurt the player Roosevelt in front, who struggles to get up. Another puck thrown towards the goal. Roosevelt couldn't get to it. He's just basically playing on one leg at the moment after that shot block. Now Taylor Pyatt's able to kick the puck forward. Checked at the Vancouver line by Salo, but he forces the puck in deep. Canucks pick it up and swing it ahead to Alex Burrows. Rink wide at center. Daniel Sedin plays the puck in, and the Canucks start an early change. On comes the line of Kessler between Mason Raymond and David Booth. Verbata in on the right wing. Centers the puck and taking a swing at it was Hanzel, who looks like he was high stick. There's going to be a penalty to Vancouver. Hanzel was reaching for his face after that scoring chance in front. Now he's checked off the puck. There's the whistle.
Kevin Bieksa coming back, and he's looking at the referee. I thought he was the reason Hanzel couldn't get to that puck, and Kevin saying, well, I got his stick. Did he get his face also? Yes, he did.
So a power play for the Coyotes just 68 seconds into the hockey game. Hanzel stays out to take the draw. He's between Verbata and Doan up front. Canucks get the puck off the draw. Tanev rings it around past Keith Yandel and down into the Phoenix zone. Canucks did surrender a power play goal in Dallas. One of the rare occasions of late. Vancouver's been very stingy. Coyotes 30th in the league on the power play. Ray Whitney down the boards. Here's Verbata. Those two both red hot offensively. Whitney at the right point. Down for Verbata, partially disrupted by Hansen. Now the puck sent back. Here's Yandle with a slap pass, and Doan tipped it off the target. Malhotra missed the puck as he took a swipe at it, trying to move it out. Now Tanev knocks it free, and Malhotra is able to dump it down the ice. Minute 10, they go on the penalty to Kevin Bieksa. We're 2 minutes into a scoreless first period. Still no shots either way. Whitney gets to center, flips the puck in. Back goes Alex Edler. Fake going around the far side, sent it up the near boards. Held in by Whitney, but stolen by Kessler, who's able to clear the puck, and it goes off Yandle's stick and down into the Phoenix zone. .40 seconds to go on the Phoenix power play, and Schneider takes that puck with a short hop, elects to throw it to the side, and Sammy Paulson, in his first shift as a Canuck, gets the puck out. First shift comes as a penalty killer.
I don't think he was expecting the hand pass from Corey Schneider.
Coyotes break in. Nice poke check there. Busy stick of Alex Edler, and Chris Higgins gets the puck out. 15 seconds to go on the power play. Here's Rafi Torres moving in. Drops the puck back. It's chopped in behind the goal. Antoine Vermette, the newest Coyote, battles for it there. Max Lapierre trying to do something with the puck. Doing a good job of tying it up and killing seconds. And here comes Bieksa onto the ice. Coyotes still have the puck, though. Ekman-Larsson with a wrist shot. That was blocked in front. Another shot from the side, and Schneider makes a stick save. Here come the Canucks with numbers. Lapierre on the right wing. Two teammates with him. Lapierre centers for Bieksa, and a nice play by Ekman-Larsson to intercept the pass. Raymond was the trailer. Lapierre elected to try to find Bieksa, and it was broken up by Ekman-Larsson. Now from center, he dumps the puck into the Vancouver zone. Schneider's out to play it. Blocked in the corner, and here's Mikael Bakker centering just out of the reach of Taylor Pyatt. Canucks move the puck out. Dan Hamhuis. Up ahead, here's Zach Kassian moving in as he takes his first shift. And he, after the penalty jump, he gets to take his first shift with the Sedins.
He made a nice play defensively as the Coyotes turned it over and made a pass across. He was there to make sure that his man didn't tip it in.
Kassian in on the right wing, drops to the blue line, and a shot hit the outside of the post as Bieksa let it go. Bieksa again to Henrik Sedin. Bieksa checked, and the puck is played forward to Doan. Taken from him by Hamhuis, who passes to an open wing. Daniel Sedin picks up the puck there. 4.5 minutes into the first. Vermette with a steal, and his shot goes off the side of the net. Hamhuis controls behind the goal. They counted that as a shot, so Schneider must have got a piece of it before it went off the side of the goal. Shots 2-0 Phoenix. Here's Hamhuis in on the left wing. Dan Hamhuis towards the net, stopped by Smith, trying to cover up, and finally gets the whistle after making his first stop of the hockey game.
Well, right after the Kevin Bieksa penalty, when he comes out of the penalty box, the Canucks have a 3-on-1. And Max Lapierre is trying to hit Kevin Bieksa going, and Ekman-Larsson with a good defensive play. And here's Zach Kassian coming back. And he just gets stick-to-stick contact so that Taylor Pyatt can't get to that puck.
Two former high draft picks of the Buffalo Sabres. Zach Kassian, who went 13th overall in 09. Taylor Pyatt, 8th overall to the Sabres in 1999. Sedins are back out, this time with Alex Burrows, who has the puck behind the net to Henrik. Henrik Sedin comes out the near side. Still with the puck. Centers. Daniel shot it wide. Daniel rings around. Tanev moves down from the right point on Ray Whitney. Burrows gets the puck. He's bodied by Ekman-Larsson. Tanev holds it in. Now it's thrown back towards the line, but it changed direction a little bit, and Henrik Sedin couldn't react. Pass for Daniel. Broken up. Hansel plays the puck forward. Aaron Rome trying to chip it the other way. And now flips the puck forward. Picked up by Higgins, who failed to move into the Phoenix zone. Now he collides with Hansel as the Coyotes take the puck away. 5.5 minutes into the first, no score. Pyatt's in on the right wing. Working on Rome, who knocked the puck away from him. Pyatt goes back after it, but it squirts free to Higgins, who advances to Hansen. Onto the right wing. Sallow dumps one in on Smith. Paulson moving in after the rebound, so Mike Smith covers up for the whistle. Here's Murph.
Guys, don't forget about Safeway's $1 million score and win. If any Vancouver player scores 5 goals, In Barletta, Vancouver could win $1 million.
You can reach Murph all hours of the day via Twitter at Sportsnet Murph. He's got his fan club down here.
He had lots of time yesterday. He was sitting around on deadline day on Twitter.
Puck out of play, and they say it went off a Phoenix stick, deflecting out, so the faceoff will stay in the Coyotes' zone.
It's good to see Taylor Pyatt back. Remember last time the Canucks played, the day before Valentine's Day, he got KO'd in behind the net, and I thought, you know, the concussion problems, but he only missed three games, and he's back. Played the last two.
Here's Keith Yandle, who had the late goal in that game on the innocuous-looking shot from the blue line that spoiled the shutout bid of Roberto Luongo. Canucks eventually prevailing in a, what was it, a six-round shootout or seven? It was long.
Six. Six. Canucks scored four of their six.
Adler steps up and he hits Lauri Korpikoski inside the Phoenix blue line. Coyotes move the puck in. Korpikoski on the right wing throws it in front. It's loose. Schneider onto his knees, made a couple of stops in tight. Puck comes back to the blue line. Long shot from there, deflected, and Rafi Torres was providing a screen in front with Chris Summers shooting from the blue line, looking for his first career goal. Summers on the defensive now as Cassian moves in and tried to bang him in the corner. Torres able to move the puck out. Cassian and LaPierre both get a piece of him as he slides it deep into the Vancouver zone. Bieksa. Pass ahead. Puck comes free to Paulson. Now Cassian drops back into his own zone, and Schneider plays the puck over to Kevin Bieksa. Ahead to Samuel Paulson, who drops off to Dan Hanhuis. He goes up the boards to the Phoenix blue line. Higgins forces the puck in. Paulson picks it up, goes round behind the net, comes out with a wraparound attempt. It's loose. Hanson jamming away. Higgins as well. And Smith diving out, able to make the save. The puck was laying in the crease. Hanson trying to get it over the line, but neither he nor Higgins could open the scoring in this game on a glorious opportunity.
More great Canuck games are coming up, and the Bud Bus could take you there. Come by Mahoney & Sons Public House at UBC until March 3rd for your chance to win a seat on the bus and at the game. Must be legal drinking age, no purchase necessary.
Sammy Paulson almost gets his first goal on a wraparound try. It's off the skate of Mike Smith. Yannick Hansen has a whack at it. And when things are going well, look at Mike Smith. Things are going well for him. Instead of kicking it into his own net, he's able to keep it out. Stretches out, and Yannick Hansen can't make contact.
Sammy Paulson has two goals this season. You may remember one of them was a shorthanded effort at Rogers Arena for Columbus. Just offside is Doan, and then he got crunched by Rome on the whistle. Both Bodker and Doan come over to have words with Aaron Rome.
Well, Shane Doan didn't say much. The whistle came late. Shane Doan's one of those players, doesn't mind taking a hit. Been around the game long enough to know what a good hit is.
One of the many NHLers whose fathers had the privilege of playing either against or with you.
Bernie Doan in the Central Hockey League was a member of the Kansas City Blues. A rugged defenseman, but almost too nice a guy to make it.
Shane's got that attribute as well, plus
an edge.
And he's made it big time. Coyotes called for icing.
Are you really good at eating wings and watching sports? Then join the BPFL at your local Boston Pizza and start eating your way to great prizes.
You know what a big TV guy I am?
Yeah.
You ever watch Man Tracker?
No.
Shane Doan beat Man Tracker. He and his brother.
Oh, I heard about that. I read that.
Oh, yeah. Shane was unbelievable.
Offside at the Phoenix blue line.
Practically carried his brother over the finish line.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's a shame he was in such great shape. They were in the Kootenays, I think. They were in B.C. It was crazy.
Kind of like you and I on our walk today. We got lost. We're out in the sun for an hour and a half. That's why Donnie was saying I look sunburned.
Oh. He didn't have to tell everybody. We got lost.
It was rather embarrassing.
There were a couple of old men in Arizona wandering around.
Where's the golf course?
Here's David Booth centering Kessler off the underside of the crossbar. Bounced straight down, stayed out, still scoreless. Raymond tried to set up Kessler in the same spot. That one's intercepted. Puck played to center. Ham Hughes checked by Verbata. Chips it forward. Whitney to Hansel. And that puck was tipped by Whitney. And Schneider made a nice save. Penalty coming up here to Radim Verbata as he put the grab on one of the Vancouver players. Schneider heads to the bench for the extra attacker. On the delayed penalty to Verbata. Here's Kessler, who came within inches of opening the scoring moments ago. Loses the puck at center. And the whistle blows for the holding penalty.
Ratting for batter, 165 feet away from his own net, reaches out. Here's the shot by Ryan Kessler. Oh, man. I think they might have to. No, it's off the crossbar and stayed out. From the back angle, it looked like it might have hit the back post, but from that angle, obviously, it hit the bar and stayed out.
First power play of the game for the Canucks. This is an area they want to get cooking in again. They're down to tied for third in the NHL. Remember, they led the league from mid-November until just a couple of days ago. But a run of two for their last 25 has dropped them into a tie for third in the NHL with a man advantage. Edler leads for Henry. Kessler had to reach back to take that one. He backhands the puck behind the net. Smith out of his net. He'll do it himself.
The Marty Turco influence. Mike Smith, Marty Turco's backup for years in Dallas. Handles the puck very well.
First unit stays out. We expect to see Mason Raymond join the second unit with Cody Hodgson off to Buffalo. Daniel Sedin drops to Edler. Wrist one on goal. Smith the save. Rebound cleared to the side. Henrik Sedin is after it on the left wing, but it gets past him, and Doan is able to pass at center. And the puck is driven in by Damon Lanco. Schneider gets it over to Salo as the second unit comes out for Vancouver. Booth at center. Checked by Adrian Acoin. And he plays the puck back into the Vancouver end. 45 seconds to go in the penalty to Verbata. We're just past the halfway mark. First period, no score. Bieksa waits with the puck. Now defers to Dan Hamhuis. He gets to center and hammers one in. Gets it by Smith. Stepping on the puck and falling down was Summers. Canucks swing it to the blue line. Nice hold by Bieksa. Here's Hamhuis across. Booth shoots. Stick save. And the rebound came past Burrows, who was going to the net. Hamhuis holds the puck in. Raymond's after it in the corner. Comes back to Booth. Right point. Bieksa. Burrows goes to the front. Gets knocked down. Pass comes to Booth. High slot. Down the side. Here's Raymond. Two goals in his last two games. Here's Bieksa. Blue line. Moves to the middle. Kevin Bieksa doesn't shoot it. Feeds down to Hamhuis. Centers. Booth. Stop. Raymond on the rebound. Can't pull the trigger on the backhand. Raymond gets the puck. Back to Bieksa. Lets it go. Off the arm of Smith. Puck goes over the glass. Verbata's out of the box. Coyotes back to full strength, and the Canucks, despite threatening, are still in a scoreless tie.
FIFA International Friendlies on the network. Canada versus Armenia tomorrow, 8:30 on Sportsnet 1, followed by Italy versus USA. England v. Netherlands tomorrow at 11:30. And then on Sportsnet World, Germany, France, 11:30 as well. Chicha, who's your favorite on that Armenian team?
That's it. I'd like to see Canada win. But the friendlies, they take them so seriously. The European nations, the friendlies aren't so friendly.
Is this friendly? Kassian and Bissonnette?
No.
Coyotes come up with the puck, and it's sent off the boards and down into the Vancouver zone. Aaron Rome. And Torres brought that one in for another offside whistle.
But
if you're making a difference for hockey, we'd like to help. Apply for an RBC Play Hockey grant today, and you could receive funding and financial advice for hockey in your community.
Think about coming to a new conference. You don't know the tough guys. Play, obviously, you know of them, and you've been watching around, but you haven't played against them. There's not much animosity built up. That one game a year.
Yes. Rome. Bumped by Torres, puck sent up the middle. And Malhotra does well to get it out and down to the Phoenix blue line. Adrian Acoin has the puck, watched by Zach Kassian. Yandel throws the puck forward. Torres digs it out of his feet. Tried to make a pass to Bissonnette. Canucks turn it the other way. And here's Malhotra. He's got Tanev going to the net, throws it across, and the pass was a little off the mark into his skates. Tanev might have had a chance to go in alone for his first career goal. Nobody scored in this one. Just over 8 minutes to go in the first period. Higgins gets in front of that Yandel pass. Yandel gets the puck again behind the net. Vancouver penalty coming up. Delayed call. Smith to the bench, and as Paulson touches the puck, the whistle blows. Somebody on the bench is getting the penalty. And it looks like Manny Malhotra's, maybe he's coming on to kill the penalty. It's not Malhotra getting the penalty, it's Maxime Lapierre.
And it's called for interference, so Max Lapierre is looking up to see how he got caught. He's shaking his head.
Second power play for the Coyotes. Whitney has room. Let's go with a shot. That changed direction and missed the net. Puck comes free to Yannick Hansen, and he's able to send it the length of the ice. Coyotes didn't test Corey Schneider in their first power play. Spent just about half of the power play in the Vancouver end of the ice. They'll try to do better on this one, but not on that entry as Hanhuis gets the puck, but it's held in by Yandel. Now intercepted by Hansen. And he skates the puck forward before chipping it down into the Phoenix zone. Minute 25 to go on the Lapierre line. Whitney to center. Points in 13 of his last 14 games, Ray Whitney. The only team to shut him down in the last 14 was Vancouver in the shootout loss. 21 points in his last 17 games, and he stays out on the power play for the Coyotes. Vermette moves it, feeds the blue line. Yandel drags in the middle, he shoots, blocked. And here comes Ryan Kessler trying to get loose. Yandel turns on the Jets, trying to catch him. Kessler to the backhand, put it wide, trying to go high to the glove side.
Oh, he had some room.
Back comes Whitney. Vermette to the corner, throws it back, and a shot by Ekman. Larson just missed the net. Whitney on the right wing. 30 seconds to go on the power play. Vermette to the blue line. Onto the boards for Ray Whitney. Throws it across. Ekman Larson again, and Schneider made a stick save. Paulson battling for the puck in the corner. Tanev's there as well. Coyotes keep it deep. Rome out-muscled for the puck, but now it comes free and is shot down the ice by Chris Higgins. Smith aggressive out of the net, thought about playing the quick up, but elects to leave the puck for Ekman Larson behind the net.
Only 10 seconds left. He wanted his team to get a regular line on the ice.
Now the power play is over. Phoenix is 0 for 2. Coyotes managed one shot on that one. Ekman Larson. Now there's a shot by Pyatt off the left wing that's handled by Corey Schneider. Coyotes failed on the power play and also dodged a shorthanded chance. Ryan Kessler moving in on Mike Smith and just missed on the backhand.
Get access to guaranteed authentic tickets for sold-out Canucks games direct from Canucks season ticket holders. Membership $10 for the remainder of the season and playoffs. Don't risk getting turned away at the gate with invalid tickets. Join today at Canucks.com.
Good crowd here in Glendale. A lot of them supporting the visitors. And it'll be a seven-game homestand for the Canucks after this game. So they won't have to travel as far to see their favorite team.
The guys were mocking me about my sunglasses. I need a pair like that. Yesterday, a trade deadline. One of the things that Coyotes management has talked about is there's Bissonnette and Max Lapierre. No?
Cassian's having words with him now. There. And I think we got something brewing here. Maybe not.
No. One of the things that Coyotes people were talking about is if they could get the Canuck fans to become Phoenix fans on the games where the Canucks are not playing. Just get them to come, and then, okay, you can come and cheer for Vancouver when they're here, but come and cheer against some of the other teams that the Canucks don't like.
Cassian and Bissonnette in conversation as they head to their respective benches. Lapierre's part of the conversation as well.
Max is up there with the number of fights he's had this year.
Penalty minutes, too. Leads the Canucks. 118. Hyatt moves the puck in off the draw. Bieksa bumps into him. Here's Boyd Gordon. Puck comes to the near side. Roosevelt puts it towards the goal, and Schneider made a nice save with the right pad. Here's a lead pass. Daniel Sedin moves in, cuts wide. Weak shot, and he's going to draw a penalty, though, as he took a chop. They'll call it hooking. And Vancouver gets its second power play as Daniel Sedin broke in on the left wing.
Well, it's still a hook. You hook the guy, and he can't go through you, and you let the stick go. It's still a hook. Here comes the hook. Okay, there's the hook underneath the arm of Daniel Sedin. You let the stick go, but you still get the hook underneath his arm.
Roosevelt gets the penalty at 14:46. And the Canucks will try to open the scoring with their man advantage unit. Four power plays already in this first period. Salop moves to the right point, passes down. Thrown towards the goal, and in off Kessler, I think. Edler threw it on net, and I think Ryan Kessler might have redirected it to open the scoring for Vancouver.
Well, John, you and I were talking about before the game, the off-air, just keep it simple. Just get the puck, get it to the net. And that's what the Canucks have done here in this one. Get the puck, get it to the net. Kessler's there, good position. It's on Noel. It doesn't hit Kessler. It double pinballs.
Yes.
And Ryan Kessler's there. But you can see it, double pinball, and in it goes. That's one of those Chris Summers happened to be there, and it's off Summers and in.
After going originally off Adrian Acoin, I think. So it took the Canucks 10 seconds on the power play to cash in. And it'll probably be Alex Edler's goal, we think. We've been wrong before. Here's Yandel up the middle, and a glove save by Schneider knocked that puck down, and he covers up for the whistle.
Well, that's what you can create offense by the defense getting involved. Everybody else has a responsibility. Take your man, and Yandel's right down the pipe. And Corey Schneider, very aggressively, top of the crease, able to make the save.
If it is Edler's goal, I think I heard Gary Volk saying on the pregame that it had been 35 games without a power play goal for number 23. That drought may be over. Edler gets the puck behind the net. Verbata read that one well. Puts it to the side. Hansel centers. Deflected off a Canuck towards the goal line. And Schneider able to hold it out. Now a centering pass. And Schneider reaching out. Backhands that one with the glove. And hangs on for the whistle.
Now, Corey Schneider is so big. And the thing I like about him is he's so strong along the ice. Look at how strong he is. That left leg drag. Keeps it strong on the ice so that the jam play just doesn't work. You watch Thomas Bocoon play lately, and you notice how many go underneath them, and watch how Corey Schneider played that one, and you can see the difference.
It is Edler's goal from Salo and Daniel Sedin on the power play. And the Canucks are 1-for-2 and lead the game 1-0. Here comes Chris Tannen. Higgins on the left wing. Tried to throw the puck across. And that went off a skate and caromed out to center. Just over 4 minutes to go. First period. Alex Edler with his 41st point is one away from his career high set two seasons ago. Here's Yannick Hansen down the right wing. Throws on the brakes. Hansen had that puck deflected to the near corner. Rome moves down from the left point. Paulson's there for Vancouver. Puck played back. Long shot by Daniel Sedin, deflects to the far corner, and the Coyotes pick up the puck there. Hansen throws a hit on his man as the pass is made over to Roosevelt and wristed into Vancouver zone. Tanev battling Doan, who plays the puck back towards the blue line, but Coyotes were changing. Ekman Larson checked by Burrows, but couldn't poke the puck past him. Now it's loose on the near side and gobbled up by Bodker, who saw Hamuse coming up and just got out of the way. Burrows to Henrik Sedin. Bieksa aggressively joins this rush. Goes to the net. Now goes after the puck behind the goal. Tips it to the near side. Bieksa gives chase there. Throws a hit. Raymond's onto the ice. Digging for the puck along the left wing boards. Comes out with it. Raymond towards the net. puts it to the crease, gets his own rebound, and Smith reaching back, able to make the save and cover up. 2:56 to go. Canucks leading 1-0 on Alex Edler's 8th of the season. Inger Hadley of Maple Ridge on Safeway Score and Win for Safeway and Stouffer's Lean Cuisine and Red Box Entrees. You've won a Men's Boulevard Marine Star watch.
Well, Alex Edler is on the boards. Adrian Acoin, it's off his skate, off Summers, and in with Ryan Kessler making sure that at least one defenseman has to stay put and be the second pinball.
Puck out of play between the benches where Tyson Nash, the former Canuck property, does color commentary for the Coyotes, and he got out of the way of that puck.
Former Kamloops Blazer. He and Darcy Tucker were on the same team. Can you imagine?
Motor mouth.
Oh, aggravating would that be.
Here's a turnover. Edler lost the puck. Whitney breaks in on the right wing. Ray Whitney to the net. He shoots. Stopped by Schneider. Rebound. Stopped that as well. Loose puck. Kessler comes up with it. Corey Schneider looking sharp. Couple of closing chances for the Coyotes. Now at the other end, Smith tips a puck to the sideboards. Kessler tries to wrist it on goal. Winds up in the far corner. Coyotes have outshot the Canucks 11-10 to this point. Just the one goal. Belonging to Alex Edler. Raymond falls down, but able to shovel the puck ahead to Booth. Drops for Hanhuis. Wrist shot, and that missed the net. Torres picks up the loose puck. Lost it at center. Malhotra was trying to move it. Coyotes take the puck back. Here's Roosevelt, who was in the penalty box when the Canucks got their goal. Puck thrown ahead, deflected in on Schneider, who leaves for Dan Hanhuis. Hanhuis had an overtime winner in this building last season. Makes the pass ahead, and Cassian moves in with a feed to Malhotra in front for Zach Cassian, who couldn't make contact with the puck as it came towards the goal. Doan, Lanco, backhander stopped by Schneider. Went to his knees but stayed tall. Took it off his chest, and he hangs on for the whistle.
We've talked about how when a goaltender's playing well, he gets hit in the logo. And here's Ray Whitney coming in after the turnover, and where does he hit? Right in the middle of the pads, and Corey Snyder's there. Damon Lanco comes in on the back end, and where's that? Just above the logo is Corey Snyder again, off the chest and able to control the rebound.
Canucks get the puck out, Higgins after it, following up is Sammy Paulson. He's checked, and Verbata passes across onside at the Vancouver blue line. Close play, here's Yandel trying to hook one back for a coin, and that went off Higgins and out to center. Adrian Acoin. Here's Ray Whitney trying to find some room in the neutral zone. We're into the final minute of the first period. Canucks leading 1-0. Whitney again. Yandel up ahead for Rabada. Couldn't make contact. No icing as Schneider tried to make a play on the puck. Aaron Rome checked behind the net by Whitney. Here's Rabada. Down for Hansel. Rome moves to check him. Tanev after the puck, chips it forward, not out. Rabada to the line, long shot, blocked. Hansen got in front of it, the puck's out to center. Coyotes drive it back in, look out. That almost hit the referee in the corner. But just diving out of the way, I think was Chris Lee. The officials are numbers 28 and 29 tonight, making it more difficult to figure out
this broadcast position.
Who that was. It was either Ian Walsh or Chris Lee who almost got dinged. Final few seconds of the first period, and looks like the team with the most first period goals this season is going to get out with the lead. As the horn sounds, Alex Edler on the power play got the goal at 14:56, and Corey Schneider took care of the rest, stopping all 12 Phoenix shots.
This period brought to you by Prius V, the newest member of the Prius family with 50% more cargo space.
Canucks with the lead in the finale of their six-game road trip. 40 minutes to go as they try to come on home to open the seven-game homestand with another win. We'll hear from Ryan Kessler in the intermission, talking to Dan Murphy. But first, our friends. Alongside Gary Volk, here's Don Taylor.
Summary brought to you by Wireless Wave. Love the phone. Corey Schneider, perfect, stopping all 12 shots he faced. Canucks got a lucky one on Mike Smith. Not sure Alex Edler called the double bank job, but they all count, his eighth, giving the Canucks a 1-0 lead. Now it's time to meet the new guys, starting with Samuel Paulson. John.
Very good friends with Daniel Sedin. Their summer homes are about a half hour apart in Sweden. And here's a little bit more you might not know about Sammy Paulson.
Well, what a year. You win in 06, you win the Olympic gold in Torino, and then the next spring, 2007, you're hoisting the Stanley Cup. Well, I guess it's almost summer, but you're hoisting the Stanley Cup.
First game as well for Zach Cassian, the 21-year-old high draft pick of the Buffalo Sabres in 09, and came over for Cody Hodgson.
I thought he was good in the first period, made a couple of nice plays. You can see he's got hands. Play a whole lot, but was engaged with Paul Bissonnette a couple of times.
You talked about his dominance in that Memorial Cup with Windsor.
He started out in Peterborough. Was it Peterborough Pete?
Canucks with a 1-0 lead. As we get underway in period number two, Ekman Larson throws the puck forward. Taylor Pyatt backhands it in, and the goal scorer, Alex Edler, behind his net, collects the puck. Sends it ahead. Canucks have three through center. Henrik Sedin in on the right wing. Stops inside the blue line. Sends the puck down the boards. Daniel picks it up. Leaves for Henrik. Tried to find Daniel. Was going to take the puck on the ricochet, but Salo brought it out to center, and Edler drives it back in. Canucks start an early change. Raymond onto the ice. Ekman Larson passes near side for Pyatt. Over to check him is Booth. Puck comes to center. Raymond has it. Gets around Korpikoski, now flips the puck in as Roosevelt was trying to hit him. Here's Kessler, round the net, out the near side, shoots off the outside of the post. David Booth tried to feed down for Raymond. That was intercepted, and Gordon able to get the puck off the glass and out.
Well, Ryan Kessler was talking about getting bounces when he was talking to Murph. Had one off the inside of the bar that stayed out, and that one off the outside of the post.
Puck out of play behind the Phoenix bench. Our first whistle of the second period, a minute and 11 in.
Well, Ryan Kessler, he's just throwing this one at the net. I think you're playing this one more for a rebound than anything else. But you could see there was a little room over the left shoulder of Mike Smith off the outside of the post, not near as close as the one off the crossbar.
That was his best chance. Remember, he had the shorthanded bit as well on the backhander.
Oh, he didn't miss that one by much either.
Coyotes have the puck in the Vancouver zone. Centered, one-timer by Vermette is stopped, and Schneider stopped the rebound, and then another one. Vermette had three cracks at the Vancouver net, but it stays 1-0 Canucks.
Antoine Vermette has eight goals so far this season. He has a couple of great chances here. One shot, two shots, and the third one, banned on the first try, and Chris Tanev is in behind his goaltender, but Corey Schneider is able to squeeze it.
Paulson at the last moment coming over to box him out. Teammates in Columbus. Here's Way Whitney behind the Vancouver goal trying to set it. Whitney gets the puck again. Hughes cuts that one off in the corner. Sends it up the boards. Puck comes into the middle, picked up by Kevin Bieksa. Lead pass, Max Lapierre. Left wing feed, Cassian drops for Lapierre. Tried to wrist one on goal. That's off a Phoenix stick and over the glass for another whistle. Well, what a month it's been for both these teams, John. We've seen the Canucks firsthand, and then you suddenly realize there's a team that's been even better, and that's Phoenix.
Well, the Canucks, and you look at this long road trip for the Canucks, I think that's part of it, but Phoenix's record, those 11 games, they're 6-5. It's not like they've been home the whole time. They've only had six home games and five road games, so they've played very well, too.
From fourth in the division, 12th in the conference, to first in the Pacific, and the third seed in the West, despite some teams below them in the standings having more points. Schneider, right pad down, trying to hold it out, getting help from Hamhuis, no whistle.
Well, blow the whistle.
And they do. Gordon was working feverishly to try to muscle that puck over the Vancouver goal line. Hamhuis is saying the same thing you were.
Well, Mick Magoo is the supervising official, and he would have been waving his hands frantically, I'm sure, on this one. But you can see the referee is looking in the net to see if the puck goes in. The referee outside at center ice, he's not going to blow the whistle from there. We had a nice chat with Mick about the starting lineup confusion. He was straightening it out for us.
Hey, there's your show. Monday's 9, City TV Alcatraz, the bone-chilling drama from J.J. Abrams.
Missed it last night. Of course, the car race was on. NASCAR.
Just let him get a little late. Never seen anything like it. Sallow throws that one up to center, deflects off Yandel and down into the Phoenix zone. Booth hustles after the puck. David Booth trying to make something happen from the corner, checked by Yandel. And Damon Lanko has the puck for the Phoenix Coyotes. Lanko along the inboards. O'Coin having trouble, reverses for Yandel. Checked by Kessler. Canucks looking to win back possession of the puck. It's onto the stick of Rafi Torres, and he's able to slide it across to Adrian O'Coin. Back up the left wing for Torres, who moves it. Torres throws one in front. Raymond on the back check. That one deflects off him towards the crease. Puck is loose somewhere, comes free, and now a quick whistle. Summers was leaning, or loading up for a slap shot. The whistle blew. And Schneider's a little slow to get up.
Well, there was so much traffic in front. And Mason Raymond, that time, instead of taking the puck out of danger, deflects it into danger. And you can see the traffic in front is,
whoa,
there's bodies flying everywhere.
Torres propelling Sallow into the pile.
And Rafi Torres gets away with this one, knocks Sallow into Corey Schneider, and the referee right there blows the whistle. No penalty call.
Vermette with a faceoff win. Stone dumps the puck around, shot from the side by Bodker, and he whistled that one right over the glass. Just one goal in the last 24 games for Mikhail Bodker, and his frustrations continue after that chance.
Dave Tippett looks on, and he is such a good structure coach, and when you get on a roll like the Coyotes are on, your confidence gets so high, you feel like every game, okay, we're going to keep the score down, we only need one or two to win.
Bodker backhands the puck into the Vancouver zone. Bieksa works it free to Hamhuis. Pass ahead to Yannick Hansen. Tried to find Paulson, who was checked by Bodker. He turns back. Mikhail Bodker to Vermette. Touch pass in front. That deflects to Schneider. Tried to throw it ahead. Intercepted by Doan. Loose puck in front after the save, and Bodker couldn't find the handle. Coyotes still have the puck in the Vancouver zone. Centering pass at the back of the goal. Sammy Paulson gets the puck, sends it around the boards, and it rolls down into the Phoenix zone.
Almost a little too much confidence by Corey Schneider that time. He had a chance just to hang on to the puck and instead tried to play it up the middle.
Icing call against Phoenix. Bieksa gets the whistle. 4:06 into the second period.
We saw him in the first period with the hand pass to Sammy Paulson. This time, okay, fall on it, make the save play, and instead tries to throw it up the middle and then has to make two more.
16 in total for Schneider. Coyotes have outshot the Canucks 16-13. Sedin's out for this offensive zone faceoff. Burrows fishing for the puck. Daniel Sedin goes after it. Tried to hook it in front. Now Burrows from behind the net. Banks it back to Tanev. And struggling to hold the puck in. Coyotes send it the other way. Whitney in. Spins. Shoots. Wide. Hansel swoops in for the puck. Tries to center. And Tanev recovered to block that pass. Ekman-Larsson's feed down the boards. Intercepted. Henrik Sedin gets to center. Dumps the puck in. But he was on his own side. Burrows has to touch the puck. They wave it off. Originally signaling the delayed icing. It looked like Roosevelt got there first, but play continues, and the puck is sent into the Vancouver zone. Edler comes out with the puck. Ahead for Henrik Sedin, and again, icing waved off as Ekman-Larsson goes back for the puck. 5 minutes into the second, it's 1-0 Vancouver. Malhotra got in front of that pass. Zach Cassian steps into his man. LaPierre dumps the puck back into the Vancouver zone. And Edler has it over to Sammy Sallow. Cassian at center, checked by Roosevelt. Puck thrown across for Bissonnette. And now he gets himself onside and backhands the puck in deep. Schneider up the boards for Malhotra and into the middle for Maxime Lapierre. Gets to the Phoenix blue line, chips the puck in. Cassian hustles after it. Smith gets to the puck before him. Sends it to the near side. And it's dropped back by Torres. Now thrown ahead to Bissonnette, who feeds back to Stone. Michael Stone drives the puck into the Vancouver end. Torres hooks it back. Boyd Gordon with a shot off the stick of Hanhuisen and wide of the goal. Torres crashes in, gets the puck free. Gordon with a shot, stick saved by Schneider. Malhotra rings the puck around, held in by Keith Yandle. 6 minutes into the second, still 1-0 Vancouver. Here's a shot after some nice moves. And that one just went wide of the goal. Taylor Pyatt holds the puck in. Now the Canucks come up with it. Fired ahead for Lapierre. That's off a Phoenix stick and down into the Coyotes' end. Adrian Acoin has the puck. Leaves for Keith Yandle. He slides it forward. Shane Doan moves it. Puck deflects towards the goal. Rome able to pick it up and chips it around to Chris Tanev. Tanev with a pass ahead. Here's Raymond in on the left wing. Finds Kessler. Booth's in front. Kessler tried a backhander, and that was stopped by Smith, who was cheating a little for the pass. Raymond. Pass down the boards. Picked off by Yandle. He goes across to Acoin. Up the left wing, Pyatt deflects the puck in and heads for the Phoenix bench. Schneider gets the puck to Tanev, and he's able to slide it out to neutral ice. Not many whistles here in the second. We're 7 minutes in, 1-0 Vancouver. Edler got the goal on a first period power play. Mikhail Bodker, checked by Mason Raymond. Raymond comes up with the puck. No room to move it, but gets it up to Kessler. He throws it up the middle, held in by the Coyotes. Doan at the left point. Slap shot, deflected, stopped by Schneider. Another save on the rebound. Twice he stopped Antoine Vermette. First on the deflection and then sprawling with the left pad. Corey Schneider, perfect so far for the Canucks, and he's had to work for it right here off Antoine Vermette.
Safeway's featured participating product for tonight's game is Stouffer's Lean Cuisine and Redbox Entrees.
Sharon says you can put ketchup on that. Now look at Corey Schneider. Good save, good save. And Antoine Vermette, the real good goal scorers, they pull it back and then try and get it up and over the pad. And Corey Schneider's able to put the pad on top of it, and that's why the referee blew the whistle so quickly.
Phoenix has outshot the Canucks 7-2 in this second period.
The Mets just been a killer on faceoff. 4-0 in the first period.
Paulson comes out with the puck, chips it ahead for Yannick Hansen, who couldn't corral it at center, and Yandle controls for the Coyotes. Keith Yandle with a quick shift to get around Hansen. Another one at the Vancouver blue line following up his Bodker. He loses the puck, and Sammy Paulson starts back up the right wing. Hansen will try to track that puck down. Leaves for Chris Higgins. Higgins working along the boards. Paulson's there as well. Sammy Paulson in deep for Yannick Hansen. Now Higgins couldn't pull the puck through the pile. Continues to fight for it. Knocked down by Vermette. Paulson holds the puck in, but now a penalty coming up. And they're both going to go, Higgins and Vermette, I think.
Oh, it's Hansen.
Oh, is it? He's not done yet.
It'd be Hansen and Shane Doan.
Thought it was Higgins and Vermette in the corner, but you're right. Yannick Hansen's gone to the box, and there's a Coyote heading there as well, I believe.
4-on-4.
36-2 slashing. 33, Phoenix slashing.
Adrian Acoin.
Two slashing calls, Hansen and Acoin.
You're right, I thought it was along the boards too, but it was in front of the net. There's the where I thought it was going to be, and there's Hansen and Acoin. The slash and the slash. And those two get away with it. You can see those two look at the referee right away. This is the whistle went.
The ones in the corner. 8:18, the time of the coincidental minors. And 4-on-4 for the first time in the hockey game. Hansel and Verbata skate through center. With Martin Hansel playing the puck behind the Vancouver goal, Schneider sends it around for Daniel Sedin. He's checked immediately by Hansel. Puck comes free to Salo. Gets it ahead to Henrikson. Henrik to the Phoenix blue line. Throws it across. Here's Alex Edler. Into the middle, Salo has room. Back to Edler, lets it go, ripped it off the target, and the puck comes off the corner boards and down to the Vancouver blue line. Canucks change their forwards. Burrows moves in. Out there with Kessler. Burrows rings the puck around for Edler at the right point. In deep for Burrows again. Up for Kessler, out of his reach. Puck comes out to center. Hanhuis over to poke it free to Ryan Kessler, who regains his feet at the Vancouver blue line and feeds back to Bieksa.
They were lucky Alex Edler was heading off on a change.
Here come the Canucks 3-on-2. Burrows in. Dishes off as he was hit. Puck is centered. Kessler couldn't put it on goal. It was Yandel stepping up and hitting Burrows. And now Bieksa steps up and nails Antoine Vermette. And this game's getting a little edge. 35 seconds to go in the 4-on-4. Hanhuis hooked by Whitney. Play goes on. And Vermette clears the puck out. Kevin Bieksa flips the puck in from center. Booth hustles it. Smith plays the puck around for Whitney. Ten seconds to go in the penalties as Yandel brings the puck to center on the left wing. Feeds back for Stone, who shovels the puck forward. Vermette hooks it in front. Here's Whitney trying to dish off for Yandel, who took a wild swing at the puck and couldn't make contact. Penalized players are back on. Hansen is hoping for a breakaway pass. Now he gets the puck at the Phoenix blue line. In on the right wing. Still with it. Lets it go. And that was blocked by Roosevelt. Torres couldn't knock that pass down. This could be icing. And Torres lifted the stick of Tanev, so play goes on. Now Tanev's going to get a tripping penalty as he took down Shane Doan. Coyotes still have the puck. Delayed penalty to Tanev. Torres, who started all this by winning the race and lifting the stick. Here's Doan across. They couldn't get a shot away as Roosevelt bobbled the puck. Now Torres at the side is stopped by Schneider. Puck comes to the left point to Ekman Larson. They try to set it up for Doan. That'll be picked up by the Canucks. So good hustle by Rafi Torres led to the penalty for Tanev. And before that, the game's starting to heat up a little bit from a physical sense. Couple of big hits. Keith Yandel stepping up on Alex Burrows. And it was Kevin Bieksa in the neutral zone welcoming Antoine Vermette to this rivalry.
Chris Tanev in the penalty box for tripping, feeling the shame. It's a 35-year anniversary of Slapshot. Here's where a good play by Rafi Torres. They lift the stick and then Chris Tanev, he's out of position. His feet are going in the wrong direction, so he sticks a stick in the feet of Shane Doan and down he goes.
Here's a stat for you.
Okay.
These are the first penalty minutes of Chris Tanev's career.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
29 games last year. Didn't have any in the playoffs either in five games. And this is his 11th game this season as the Coyotes try a shot for a deflection that doesn't get on goal. 41 games, half a season. And he has his first penalty. Verbata moves to the middle. Whitney. Doan attacking from the side. Schneider held his ground, then came across, made another save. Might have caught a piece of the post. And the puck is swatted down to the Phoenix blue line.
Boy, oh boy, you can see Corey Schneider when he comes across how high he keeps his shoulders.
Whitney's back in. Verbata back to Whitney. Verbata, left wing hash marks. Schneider ducking around the screen, tracking the puck as the Coyotes try to throw it in front, and that's deflected out to center. Under a minute to go on the penalty to Tanev. Just under 8 minutes left, second period. 1-0 Canucks. Hansel's in. Third power play for Phoenix. They manage only one shot on their first two. Schneider's been tested on this one. Verbata has the puck in the corner. Goes round the net. Finds Doan. Tried to get a shot on goal. Deflected through to Schneider, who was able to squeeze the pads and then get the glove on the puck. And here we go again after the whistle. Hansen dragged his man out of the pile. And everybody responds to that.
No, they didn't like the way Sammy Salo was being treated at the side of the net, and it was Shane Doan. The end of the power play. Shane Doan fakes pass, takes the shot. And Corey Steiner makes a reasonable save and comes across. Look at the shoulders. Look at how high he keeps his shoulders to cover as much of the net as he possibly can. Comes across and up goes the shoulders. He gets enough of it so that it's off the left shoulder and then off the crossbar.
34 seconds to go in Chris Tanev's penalty. BX against the puck and quickly makes a move behind the net and wrists it down the ice. Yandel starts out for Phoenix. 20 seconds to go on the man advantage. Yandel dumps the puck behind the net. Schneider cuts it off, takes his time before sending it around. And Hanhuis from the corner able to send the puck to center. Under 10 seconds to go on the penalty to Tanev. Bodker tries to move it, chips the puck to the far side. Hanhuis is there first. Sends the puck around. That'll be held in by Vermette to the blue line. Ekman Larson. Tanev's back into the game. Phoenix 0 for 3 on the power play. Managed a couple of shots on that one. Three total on their three-man advantages, and now the puck goes out of play behind the Vancouver net.
Because when the game can go wherever you go, you never know when your next battle will start. Console-level gaming, anytime, anywhere. PlayStation Vita.
Kevin Bieksa shaking this one off as it hit his hand, and you can see this long shot from Ekman Larson. And Kevin's playing goaltender, up goes the right hand to steer it up into the netting.
Aaron Rome tips the puck free in his own zone. Tanev tried to help it along. He was knocked down by Taylor Pyatt. Korpikoski in after the puck. Throws it in front. Good job there by Henrik Sedin to tie up Boyd Gordon. And Daniel comes out for Vancouver. Stops just inside the blue line. Backhands the puck in behind the net. Henrik and Ekman Larson are after it. It's picked up by Gordon. Up to Korpikoski. Lead pass. Here's Pyatt moving in with a shot. Schneider, another save. Can't reach the rebound. Then he did as it came off Aaron Rome and back towards Schneider. And he's able to get the whistle.
Well, Aaron Rome is able to just slide it back to his goaltender. Aaron Rome got caught flat-footed at the blue line, but then comes back to help out defensively. Taylor Pyatt's by him at the top of the crease. Corey Schneider again, those shoulders up, makes the save.
Statistically this season, second periods have been the worst for the Vancouver Canucks. And they're still up 1-0, but they've been outshot 12-2 here in the middle frame. Schneider with 24 saves as the Canucks have been outshot 24-14. Edler rings the puck around. Malhotra gets it free to Lapierre. Here's Salo driving along on him. Just missed the net. Puck sent to the blue line and out. Alex Edler throws the puck forward. Zach Cassian picks it up. Picks up speed. Now makes a nice pass to Malhotra. He's checked. Puck winds up in the corner. Cassian holds it in. To the left point, one timer, and gloved by Smith, a shot by Edler that was likely going high. Another mix-up after the whistle, and we'll see lots of that for the rest of the night, I think. Well, they didn't count that Edler shot as a shot on goal, and it's probably the right call because it was heading over top of the net, so the Canucks are still stuck on two shots this period, John, as Mason Raymond comes onto the ice, hoping to extend his goal-scoring streak to three games. Kessler's had his chances in this one.
He has. And Phoenix has had the only power play here in the second, and they did look good on their power play. So the shots being so lopsided, it hasn't been a whole lot of chances.
David Booth after the puck off the draw. Kessler taken down at the side of the net. Now gets back up to try to check Yandel, but Verbata picks up the puck and throws it forward to Hanzel. He one-hands the puck into the Vancouver zone, tries to send it towards the goal. Kessler goes back, steps into his man behind the net, then gets grabbed. Play goes on. Whitney holds the puck into the left point. Hanzel to Verbata. Across for a coin who was sneaking in. That went off of Vancouver stick. Puck comes free to Whitney, who swings it on goal. That was blocked. And a nice play by Rome to find some room and get the puck out. Just under 5 minutes left, second period. Alex Edler, the game's only goal. Sammy Paulson dumps the puck in for Vancouver. Coyotes start out on the far side. A coin, headman's to center. Here's Vermette moving in. Pass for Whitney. He's checked. Paulson gets the puck and slides it over to Dan Hamhuis. Up to Yannick Hansen. Wrist shot. There's the third shot of the period. Smith handles it. Hangs on for the faceoff. And Yannick Hansen and Shane Doan have words again. Yannick Hansen has got a little bee in his bonnet here in this period.
Has played a spirited game. It's too bad the ownership situation, and one of the leaders on this team, Shane Doan, obviously, but to keep the players focused, and give Dave Tippett credit, but it, year after year after year, and oh, there's going to be new owners, oh, it's going to be taken care of, and it never seems to happen.
Good crowd for this one, although a lot of it wearing blue. Here's a centering pass, Daniel Sedin checked before he can get a shot away. Bodker gets the puck ahead. And here's Roosevelt joining the rush. Poke check to the blue line. That forced the Coyotes offside. 4 minutes to go in the second, and here's Murph.
Well, you should pick up Sportsnet Magazine's 2012 Beauty and Sport Edition, the 30 hottest athletes on the planet, also in the issue. On newsstands now, the Little Big League, Quebec Pee Wee Hockey Tournament, and loyal to the end, there's no place like home for the Senators, Daniel Albertson.
I almost got to play in the Quebec Pee Wee Hockey Tournament. The Peterborough Pee-wee team had picked me up, and then the parents decided that they didn't want imports. After I'd practiced, had gone to Peterborough for about 6 weeks, the parents decided, no, they didn't want an import.
I'm just glad the end of that sentence wasn't, I almost got to pose for that issue.
Oh.
Here's Zach Cassian behind the Phoenix goal. Pokes the puck to the corner, skates onto it there. Now takes a hit from Summers. Puck stays deep in the Phoenix end. Stone chips it free. Cassian there to intercept. Nicely back. Hamhuis with a drive and a nice save by Smith. As Zach Cassian teed it up for Dan Hamhuis. But the puck stayed out and now it's out of play behind the Phoenix bench.
Tyson Nash ducking. And Bissonnette still chatting.
With Cassian, who made a nice play to set up Dan Hamhuis for that one-timer.
Talk about Dan Murphy on Twitter. Paul Bissonnette is one of the busiest tweeters in the NHL. A lot of the guys use it now, but Bissonnette is probably more famous for that than playing on the ice. Is nasty.
Laurie Korpikoski chips the puck into the Vancouver zone. Daniel Sedin, first man back. Hyatt tried to check in. Rome gets the puck to Bieksa. Ahead for Burrows, checked by Korpikoski. Here's Korpikoski from behind the net, throws it in front. Pyatt couldn't get a shot away as Bieksa checked it, knocked him down. Fans wanting a penalty. Play goes on, and the puck is dumped into the Phoenix end. Boyd Gordon back to pick it up. Flips the puck ahead, knocked down. Here's Cassian dishing off, goes to the net, stopped by Smith. Another shot by Raymond, stopped by Mike Smith as well. Zach Cassian set up by Henrik Sedin. Got a good shot away, but denied his first goal as a Canuck. Kessler moves in. Wrist shot attempt, deflects to Cassian on the right wing. Plays the puck in for Kessler. Cassian taking the spot of David Booth for this shift. But Henrik was still on the ice when his shift started. Here's Hansel through center, dumping the puck into the Vancouver zone. Handler throws a hit on Hansel behind the net. Canucks flip the puck forward, Hansen after it. And again, it goes out of play at the bench area with a minute 49 to go in the second.
Mike Smith reads this one really well. Henrik Sedin's got it. And look at Mike Smith. He's leaning that way already. Gets the left pad down. And then on the second play by Mason Raymond, makes another good save. And you can see Cassian robbed by Mike Smith.
Playing the what-if game. As it almost squeaked under the pad, you can see on the replay.
Little room.
Summers. Oh, that hit Tanev up high, but he's all right. Hansen trying to get the puck out, held in by Summers. Canucks another chance to clear, and this time Hansen's able to lift it past the defenseman and down into the Phoenix zone. Hansen picks up the puck, sends it in front. Shot back out by the Coyotes. Cam Hughes gets it across to Tanev. Hansen with a nice play ahead. Here's Paulson in on the right wing. Sammy Paulson with a long wrist shot, steered to the corner by Smith. Cam Hughes held the puck in originally. Now it's out and back in for an offside whistle with a minute 10 to go. And again, here's Murph.
Guys, it's the ultimate pizza party contest from Pizza Hut and the Vancouver Canucks. Visit your local Pizza Hut for your chance to win tickets to watch a Canucks game from a private suite. Contest rules and entry forms available at canucks.com/ultimate pizza party. Brought to you by Pizza Hut, the official pizza of the Vancouver Canucks.
Little defense shuffling here, John.
Yeah, I noticed last couple shifts.
And here we have Kevin Bieksa with Aaron Rome.
And Houston Chan have last shift. They keep Edler and Salo together, it would appear. Final minute, second period. Canucks have had the last five shots in the period. Here's Ekman Larson trying to load up for one. Loses the puck and the Canucks break out. Henrik Sedin to Daniel Sedin. Down the left side. Shoots. Glove saved by Smith. Six shots in a row for the Canucks. And Smith looks sharp making that save.
Well, top goal scorer for the Canucks has that chance. And Mike Smith out to challenge. Now Daniel's a left-hand shot, so the angle's not great. He's out the face-off dot. And Mike Smith flashes the leather.
Phoenix without a shot on goal in the last 8 minutes. As the Canucks have taken over a little bit, they're offside as Edler tried to hold that puck in at the left point. 40 and a half seconds to go in the second period.
Dave Tippett looks on. They really like Antoine Vermette because he can skate so well. And I think Don Maloney and Dave Tippett think he can score. He gained his reputation in Ottawa as a real flyer and the potential to score. I don't know whether he's got that goal-scoring potential for the amount of money he makes.
Cassian continues on in David Booth's spot for another shift. I don't know if Booth has been shaken up or if this is just Alain Vigneault mixing things up. Raymond holds the puck in. Walks the line, passes to the side. Cassian turns in the corner. Zach Cassian fights off a check, tries to feed the blue line. That's broken up, and here comes Yandel for Phoenix with a long shoot-in wide of the goal. And that'll do it. Period two comes to an end. Alex Edler still the only goal scorer in the hockey game. Corey Schneider was busy in the first half of that second period. Phoenix outshot the Canucks 12-8. But Schneider stopped all 24, and Mike Smith has been beaten once on 20 shots. We've got part two of a Kevin Bieksa feature coming up in our second intermission. Canucks up 1-0 here in Glendale as we send it back to Don.
Summaries brought to you by Panago. Before, during, and after the game, it's got to be Panago. One goal in this game, Alex Edler's eighth, came on the power play in the first period as the Canucks took a 1-0 lead in the second. The Coyotes ran the show for about the first 15 minutes before the Canucks came on late.
Updated look at the West as the Canucks back into a tie with Detroit in points. And if the Canucks were to lose this one in regulation, they'd slip behind the Red Wings. But you see Phoenix there with the third seed, despite fewer points, and a couple of teams below them, John.
Well, Nashville lost in Carolina tonight, so that was a big loss for them.
Dave Tippett's team 2 points up on the Sharks in the Pacific Division. Win your division, you get a top three seed. Win this game, they're going to have to come from behind. Dallas able to do it for the overtime win two days ago, I guess. And underway in the third period. Canucks with that result in Dallas, 26-0-1 when leading after two. Look out, it's going to perhaps be a tie game on the Schneider giveaway, but Doan couldn't find the handle. And Corey Schneider's maybe going to have to start making quicker plays with the puck out of the net.
That one, just so much hesitation. He wanted to make a direct pass and couldn't.
Canucks move up the ice. Shallow with a drive. Stick save by Mike Smith. Mikhail Bodker gets the puck. Checked by Daniel Sedin. Burrows. Tied up along the boards. Roosevelt sends the puck across. Now takes a return pass at center. Moves in on the right wing and flips the puck to the far corner. Antoine Vermette is there. Puck dumped around to the near side. Edler for Vancouver, watched by Verbata. Reverses to Salah. Whitney intercepts his pass for Raymond, but Mason Raymond steals the puck back and gets it ahead. Here's Zach Kassian staying on this line with Kessler and Raymond. David Booth is at the bench. But Kassian continues to skate with these two. Now Raymond's going to draw a penalty as he was pulled down, and the Canucks get a power play, a minute 18 into the third.
Well, that created a chance. That's why Martin Hansel's headed to the penalty box. And Corey Snyder, now make your play. Make your decision. Ooh, and Shane Doan, it's off the pads, and he just can't get control. Okay, throw it along the boards. No, he changed his mind. And Shane Doan was right there, but just couldn't take advantage.
Third power play for the Canucks. They're 1-for-2. After getting the double deflection goal from Alex Edler that pinballed in off a couple of Coyote players. Edler and Salah are on the point. Sedin's and Kessler up front, and the puck is cleared down the ice by Roosevelt. Edler rushes to center. Drops for Kessler. He works his way to the Phoenix line, dishes the puck over to Daniel Sedin. Daniel back to Edler. Daniel Sedin again. Kessler at the side, centers the puck. Salah takes it on the backhand, fires back to Edler. Slap shot, deflects to the corner. Henrik Sedin there, centers for Kessler. He goes behind the net. Out the near side with a bank pass back for Edler. Did well to hold the puck in. Just over a minute to go on the power play. Here's Salah, bobbled the puck a bit. Gets it again on the right wing, back to Edler. Towards the goal, deflected by Henrik. Didn't get through, puck cleared to the line, held in by Edler. Daniel Sedin on the left wing. Henrik back to Daniel, over to Edler. Edler with a wrist shot, stopped by Smith with Kessler looking for the tip. Henrik Sedin from the corner. Round the near side to Daniel. Henrik from the corner again. 40 seconds to go on the man advantage. Canucks looking for a 2-0 lead. Salah with the blue line. Slap shot, kicked out by the right pad. Henrik Sedin tried to send one across. Couldn't get it through, but now Daniel has the puck on the right side. Henrik to Daniel. Back to Salah. Good pressure. Henrik. Salah, slap shot off the stick of Kessler, wide of the goal, and the puck is cleared by the Coyotes down into the Vancouver zone. Only 10 seconds remaining as Bieksa starts out with the puck. Room at center, and he moves in. Trying to go through, puck slides to the goaltender. Smith clears it himself. Out of the box is Hansel, trying to get behind Room. Hansel in on goal, hit the post! Almost a tie game right there. The exit towards the net, and that goes wide. Canucks spent a minute and a half of their power play in the Phoenix end. Managed a couple of shots. And then gave up the chance to Hansel as it came to an end. But it's still 1-0 as Booth tries to make a power move in front. Puck comes to Burrows in the corner. Alex Burrows back to Kevin Bieksa. Wrist shot stopped easily by Smith with no traffic in front. Booth, centering pass for Burrows, deflects to the corner. Burrows turning with the puck. Behind the net for Booth. Knocked away from him. Picked up by Mason Raymond. Pass down the boards. Picked off. Adrian DeCoin has the puck. Slides it over to Keith Yandle. Nicely ahead. Here's Lanko moving it. Damon Lanko throws the puck across. Kicked away by Bieksa. Booth able to slide it forward for Chris Higgins. As the Canucks complete their change, the Coyotes send the puck forward, and Torres wrists it into the Vancouver zone. Schneider quickly to the side to Tanner, who goes around for Dan Hanhuis. Hanhuis pressured by Hansel, gets the puck ahead to Hansen. Higgins moves in with a wrist shot, fought off by the goaltender Smith, who had trouble with that one. Canucks are now out shooting the Phoenix Coyotes in the hockey game, 26-25. That means the Canucks have outshot Phoenix 14-1. Since the 8-minute mark of the second period. Paulson moves in with a shot and another stick save by Mike Smith. Paulson dabbles with the puck in the corner. Lapierre's there as well for Vancouver. Here's Sammy Paulson to the blue line. Edler quickly over to Salo. And he chips the puck down into the far corner where Hanzel battles with Lapierre. Puck sent out to center. Malhotra onto the ice to pick it up. Passes over to Alex Edler. 5.5 minutes into the third. Canucks protecting a 1-0 lead. Sammy Salo to Alex Edler, and he hammers a long one in, stopped by the stick of Smith, who's going to try another breakaway pass. Doan offside of the Vancouver blue line. Couldn't corral the puck anyway. They blow it down.
Well, right after the penalty, and you could hear Corey Snyder banging his stick on the ice and saying Martin Hansel's coming out of the box. Mike Smith off the boards, perfect bank shot, and Hansel's onside. He snaps it, and it's off the outside of the post. Hansel's got his head up. Corey Snyder got a little piece of that off the glove.
They always do, don't they?
What a great save.
Face off in the Phoenix zone. Vermette will take it against Zach Cassian as Kessler gets waved out. Been a tough night on the draw for both Henrik Sedin and Ryan Kessler. Canucks had possession of the puck, but now it's thrown forward to Shane Doan. Sends one in, wide of the Vancouver goal. Cassian goes back for the puck, gets it back for Rome, and around for Raymond. Tried to work the puck up the boards for Kessler. That was blocked. Doan from behind the net, pulling away from Rome. Here's Vermette. Blue line feed. Yandel to a coin. Slap shot. Schneider the save, and the rebound winds up in the corner. Canucks get it ahead to Kessler. Cross for Zach Cassian at center. And he gets the puck in deep to start a Vancouver change. Little over 6 minutes gone, third period. Bodker turning at his own blue line. Michael Roosevelt. Moving in is Boyd Gordon. Tried a sharp angle shot, blocked by Tanner. Daniel Sedin gets the puck. Sends a long one for Burrows to chase after. It's going to come right to the goaltender. And he rings the puck around for Taylor Pyatt. Henrik Sedin drops the puck back into his own zone. Daniel's there to pick it up. And he goes off the glass and out. Hansen chasing after that one. Smith gets the puck to the side. Hansen steals it. Yannick Hansen makes a move to the corner. Finds some room there. Fires back. Salo tried a tip pass. But it went over his stick and down into the Vancouver zone.
Good read by Dan Hanyes.
And a quick up to Paulson. Down for Higgins, who tried his shot. And the other number 20, Summers, able to tip that one off the target. Hansen works to hold the puck in the Phoenix end. Battling against Bissonnette. Paulson gets the puck. Higgins throws it in front. Summers intercepts. That was Stone intercepting, and he banks the puck out to center. Played forward again by Salo. Michael Stone across to Chris Summers. Pass for Bissonnette at center. Nice lead feed. Here's Torres in. Wrist shot. Glove saved by Schneider. Did the splits and grabbed the puck. His 28th save of the night, and it's still 1-0 Canucks.
Head downtown and check out the newest Canucks Team Store location on Robson Street between Butte and Thurlow. It's open 7 days a week. The Canucks Team Store in Robson features a great selection of Canucks merchandise, including the new Canucks scarf. The Canucks Team Store, where the players shop.
One of the keys to being a good goaltender is you get ready early, you keep your feet still. Look at Corey Snyder, ready early, feet are still, and that way you're able to react in either direction. And he's able to react with the left hand and make the save.
Here's David Booth at center. He and Lapierre move in after the puck in the Phoenix zone. Away with it is Hansel, four Coyotes to center. Yandel takes the drop pass. Checked by Malhotra. Booth gets the puck, can't get it out. Here's Verbat at the side, stopped by Schneider. Booth ties up his man. Bieksa tripped up in the corner, keeps after the puck. Hooks it towards the middle again. It stays in the zone, but Booth this time able to get it ahead to Lapierre. And he's able to force the puck, knock the stick out of Yandel's hand. He complains to the referee as both those players head to their respective benches. Oh, Coming up on the 9-minute mark, third period. Shane Doan ahead to Antoine Vermette. Wrist shot, Schneider the save, rebound. He tried to poke it away from Doan. Kessler comes back for the puck. And he gets it off the boards and out. Chris Summers inside his own line. Ahead for Bodker, past him and up to Doan. Now to Mikhail Bodker. In on the right wing, throws on the brakes, rink-wide feed, set up in front, shot by Summers, stopped by Schneider, loose at the side, he held that out as well, as Doan was trying to muscle it home. Doan and Kessler mix it up behind the play as the puck is iced. And the fans react as Kessler knocked Doan's stick out of his hands. Here's Murph.
Well, shop and swipe your club card at Safeway today, watch future Sportsnet telecasts, and you could win a 52-inch Sharp Aquos TV with Quattron technology.
Now, do you think Dan Hamm is trying to hit the net with that one? I think he was. Why else would you fire that one down? He had lots of time to go the alley-oop.
These guys are good.
They are good. And especially him.
Off the mark, so the face on the next zone. A chance in front for Whitney, and Schneider dragged the pad and got a piece of it.
Now that one, I think, went through and came out the other side.
The goalie always gets a piece of the
shot. I know. I know that's part of my mantra, but that one, I think, went through and came out the other side.
And of the long shooting, Schneider, big rebound. Whitney again scores. They won't hold him off the score sheet this time. Ray Whitney now has points in 14 of the last 15 games as he ties this one at one.
Well, the Canucks never did get to change from their icing. And here's a long shot by Yandel, and Corey Snyder would like to have that rebound back, and Ray Whitney just backhands it and it goes through. Here's a long shot, and Corey Snyder's trying to absorb it in his pads instead, and then goes to Ray Whitney, who finds some room,
19th for Ray Whitney, 58 points. And the Coyotes on their 30th shot of the hockey game get their first goal to tie this game at one. Sammy Salo chips the puck out for Vancouver. Summers has it across to Stone. Hard pass to Torres, who moves in on the left wing. Yandel and a coin get the assist on the Whitney goal. Salo, again off the glass and out. Hansen chasing after the puck on the right wing. Yannick Hansen cutting towards the goal. He shoots. Smith the save. Higgins after the rebound. Chris Higgins bumped in the corner by Torres. Puck is centered. Shoveled wide. Henrik Sedin gets it. Down for Yannick Hansen. Leaves in the corner for Henrik. Trying to get away from Lanco. Henrik goes behind the net. Comes out the near side. Behind the goal for Hansen. Yannick Hansen finds some room on the wing. Sends the puck across. Here's Tanev in deep. Centering. Just tip wide. Henrik Sedin comes out front on the backhand. Tried to send the puck across, and it's off a leg and out to center. Henrik, now joined by his line mates, again has his pass blocked, and the puck ricochets into the Vancouver end. Matthews up the boards for Henrik. Tied up by Taylor Pyatt. Just under 9 minutes left in the third, a 1-1 tie. Alex Burrows at center. Crisscrossing with Daniel Sedin, who takes his pass. Daniel in front for Burrows, and he couldn't steer the puck on goal. Gordon clears. Rome at his blue line. Plays the puck forward right to Oliver Ekman-Larsson, and he chips it behind the Vancouver net. Rome intercepted by Korpikoski. Puck thrown in front, knocked away by Malhotra, and brought out by David Booth. Booth with a good burst down the left wing. Then he ran into Michael Roosevelt. Canucks keep after the puck. Booth with a sharp angle shot, stopped by Smith. Canucks are up to 30 shots in the hockey game. Here's Lapierre chipping one wide of the goal. Smith leaves the puck behind the net. Roosevelt run over there by Malhotra. Puck cleared to the line, held in by Bieksa. Malhotra's after it. Fan on his centering pass. Hansel sends the puck ahead. Korpikoski relays to the goal scorer Whitney, and he flips the puck into the Vancouver end. Aaron Rome around to Kevin Bieksa. Plays the puck ahead. Zach Cassian was tied up by Keith Yandel. Smith's out to play the puck. Throws it up the middle. Tip forward by Verbata. not with a high stick, and Whitney moves in on the right wing. Pass through, Verbata picks it up, finds Hansel. Whitney's in front. As Verbata tried to make a move, and Kessler knocked the puck away from him. Now he gloves it forward and skates to center with Zach Cassian. Kessler in, cuts right, still has the puck. Stops in the corner. Yandle bounces off him. Kessler behind the net for Cassian. Tried to find Raymond, that didn't work. Raymond makes a move to the corner. Mason Raymond to Zach Cassian. Nicely to Raymond. Lost an edge, gets back up with the puck, now runs into Whitney. And the Coyotes bring the puck out. Angel's got the clamp on Kessler's stick as the Coyotes go offside, but they're going to call Kessler for hooking. Coyotes tied, heading to the power play, and that man is the reason this game is even at one. Apologies to Ryan Kessler. I had the wrong right-handed forward for the Canucks heading to the box.
Well, Zach Cassian, remember Roosevelt's penalty in the first period? It doesn't matter if you let the stick go or not. You've got the stick right underneath the guy's arm, and Zach Cassian, very similar to that penalty in the first period, is off for hooking.
Hansel wasn't about to let it go. Had it there long enough for the official to see, and now the Coyotes get their fourth power play. They're 0 for 3, four shots. But an opportunity to take their first lead. They'll have to start from their own end as Burrows gets the puck all the way down. Here comes Whitney. Couple of moves, gets into the Vancouver zone. Puck knocked away from him. Now stolen by Burrows. Kessler's going to bolt at center as Burrows moves in on the right wing. Burrows brings the puck in front, gets it back, turns, can't get a shot away as the Coyotes recovered to check him. Minute 25 to go on the penalty to Zach Cassian. Hansel banks the puck to himself on the left side. Phoenix able to set up. Pass back, Yandle. Whitney to Yandle. Wrist here in front, blocked easily by Hamhuis, who didn't get all of his clearing attempt, but got enough to get the puck out. Bieksa heads to the bench, Shallows on to replace him. Verbata turning with the puck, finds Ray Whitney. Under a minute to go on the penalty to Cassian. Bodker's in on the left wing. Down the boards, Doan looks in front. Pass for Verbata went through his legs. Whitney gets the puck. Knocked away by Hamhuis. And Hansen finds Malhotra, who backhands the puck deep into the Phoenix end. 35 seconds to go on the power play. 5.5 minutes remaining, third period, a 1-1 tie. Coyotes haven't tested Corey Schneider on this power play. He's out of the net to play the puck. Coyotes hold it in. Ekman Larson with a wrist shot, blocked in front. Torres trying to come up with a rebound. Canucks find it, and it's sent down the ice by Edler. Dozen seconds to go on this power play for Phoenix. Ekman Larson, pass ahead. Bodker couldn't take it cleanly, but he moves in on Hamhuis. Puck comes to Vermette in the corner. Back to the line, Ekman Larson, here's a coin, penalty's over, and the puck is off of Vancouver's stick and out of play for a whistle. Phoenix 0 for 4 with a man advantage, and the game still tied at 1. Here's the game review brought to you by Intact Insurance. You're back.
Alex Edler on the power play. A big power play goal. Zach Cassian's looked good. I don't think he'll like those two penalty minutes. Ray Whitney, okay, 3-game goal streak, but how about 13 of the last 14 games now. Ray Whitney has put up points.
Connected coming up right after the game. And also want to remind you our next telecast is the Canucks return home Thursday, the Blues in town. Coverage begins at 6:30, the start of a 7-game homestand. Sammy Shallow in deep for Zach Cassian. Shielding the puck from Yandle. Knocked away from him, right to Edler, who shoots. Knocked down by Smith, and Cassian going hard to the front, couldn't come up with a rebound out of the air. Kessler almost ran into Cassian. Hyatt moves the puck in with a pass to Gordon. His shots turned aside by Schneider. Kessler wants to start a change, so he flips the puck into the Phoenix zone. Adrian Acoin has it. Up ahead to Bodker, moving in on Rome. Try to get around him, and Rome was having none of that. Bodker still has the puck, though. 4 minutes to go in the third, a 1-1 tie. Doan in front, Bodker couldn't pull the trigger, and the Canucks get the puck ahead to Henrik Sedin. Bieksa joins him. Daniels the trailer. Henrik drops. Daniel shoots, and a stick save by Smith. Shots are now 32 apiece in the hockey game. Henrik being grabbed behind the net. The many Canuck fans in attendance respond to that. Roosevelt has the puck for Phoenix. Here's Vermette onto the right wing. Doan with a shot, grabbed by Schneider, and he hangs on for the whistle.
Your PS3 stays home, but the game goes with you. Never stop playing. PlayStation Vita.
Amazing how the Canucks bring out the best in the Coyotes, at least at home. More Canuck fans here. The crowd's into it. On the road, the Coyotes play a more conservative game, but here they have had lots of shots and lots of scoring chances.
Hasn't translated into success necessarily against the Canucks, who've got a little run of wins here in this building. This one all even with just over 3 minutes remaining in regulation. Yannick Hansen missed the puck, but it's out to center. Stone in his own blue line. Fires it ahead, blocked by Salo, picked up by Torres. Bad pass, Hansen picks it off, and here he goes. Yannick Hansen in towards the goal. He shoots, stopped by Smith, who covers up. And then Torres, well after the whistle, went in and gave Hansen a bump in the corner and had some words for him, although they might have been friendly. I don't think he liked the turnover much.
Now here's Yannick Hansen. He has an angle, takes a look. Mike Smith's out well. Takes the shot and absorbs it.
Wonder if Hansen called for the puck. Maybe that's what Raffy was upset about.
Danny kind of has a unique voice, though. You think Raffy would recognize it from years past.
A coin whistles the puck into the Vancouver zone. Antler chips it up the boards. Here's Raymond. To Cassian at center. He bobbled the puck. Kessler follows up and chips it in. Canucks are offside. So Kessler tags up and play continues with 2.5 minutes to go in the third. Whitney's in. Lees for Verbata, who plays the puck to the far side. Whitney picks it up there. In front for Verbata, tipped away by Edler and down into the Phoenix zone. Both teams changing. 2:10 to go in the third. Boyd Gordon bounces one in. Schneider had to be careful of that as the bounce took a left turn towards him and he hangs on.
Intact Insurance, proud sponsor of the Vancouver Canucks and all the fans who never miss a game. Intact Insurance, you're back.
John, we talked about the excitement here because there is so many Vancouver fans. The coaches still are matching lines, though, right to the bitter end. And that last Ryan Kessler shift was about 8 seconds long because he saw he wasn't out against his designated line.
Hansen trying to negate an icing, but it's Yandel who gets to the puck first. Canucks 8-3 on the faceoff dot this period. And Malhotra's going to have to take another one for Alain Vigneault deep in the Vancouver zone.
Much better than the 14-30 that they were. After two periods.
Yannick Hansen.
The old stall tactic.
Got the clean shield. Malhotra will hope for a clean win against Vermette. And he gets it. Bieksa around, nobody there. Yandel holds the puck in. Bieksa will try again from behind the net. Up the near side. And down to the Phoenix blue line. Minute 40 to go, Yandel. Long shooting. Schneider steers that to the side. Now the puck is center. Turning is Vermette. And it went off the toe of his stick. Hansen flips the puck forward. And Smith has to play it. Now he gives it away to Higgins, who threw it across. Nobody there. Coyotes through center. Offside is Bodker. Delayed call. Coyotes vacate the zone and play continues. And Hughes ahead to Higgins. Deflects one towards the goal. And that was a bouncer that Smith had to be careful with. He'll hang on for the faceoff in the Phoenix end.
Well, that's one of the dangers when the goalie handles the puck as much as Mike Smith does. The defensemen don't come back, so Smith is just throwing it blindly. And Adrian Acoin takes his time coming back. And here's the last one, Chris Higgins. Again, the tip-in bouncer that Mike Smith is able to handle.
Henrik Sedin on the draw against Boyd Gordon. Puck underneath him. Burrows digs it free, cuts towards the goal, tries a sharp angle shot, stopped by Smith. Final minute, third period. 1-1 tie. Daniel Sedin being pursued by Lori Korpikoski. Puck comes around to Sammy Salo. Pass for Burrows, couldn't take it cleanly. And Taylor Pyatt is onto the puck, feeding it back to Oliver Ekman-Larsson. Ahead to Korpikoski, who chips the puck into the corner. Gordon and Salo go back after it. Edler gets the puck. He runs into Pyatt. Loose in front is Korpikoski. But the puck winds up on the stick of Mason Raymond, who chips it ahead for Alex Burrows. Burrows will stay on to join this rush. Now he peels to the bench as Raymond moves in on the left wing with a wrist shot off the blocker of Mike Smith. Hansel gets the loose puck, being hounded by Kessler. Now it's stolen by Raymond. Mason Raymond fell down. And the Coyotes clear the puck out, picking it up as Whitney in on the right wing. Whitney shoots, a blocker saved by Schneider. 5 seconds to go in the period. Kessler knocked down, and that'll do it for regulation. Another point for the Canucks. Phoenix gets one as well, thanks to the Ray Whitney goal here in the third. And wouldn't you know it, Corey Schneider's team is off to overtime again. 60 minutes done, it's 1-1 here in Glendale.
This overtime, brought to you by Cialis. Ask your doctor if Cialis is right for you.
Vancouver Canucks, last game, went to overtime. That was their first loss of the season. Mike Ribeiro sending it to overtime. Erickson winning it, but they're 5-1 on the year. Bieksa again at the blue line. Drags the puck to the middle. Wrists one on goal. They score!
Emmett was in front. I think he tipped it. And the Canucks in overtime win 3-2.
Henrik Sedin to Alex Edler. In front for Kessler. He couldn't make contact. Trying to tip it in. Oshie hustles to the bench. And they score! A shot from the side. Daniel Sedin has won it. Henrik goes behind the net, stops there, reverses to Daniel. Salo sneaking in. Pass comes to Henrik on the end boards. Henrik behind the net, centers Daniel, scores! A record-setting goal! His 10th overtime winner for the Vancouver Canucks. And Daniel Sedin gives Vancouver a 3-2 victory.
That goal by Daniel Sedin came in the final game of January. So, why not in the final game of February? As he takes his 10 career overtime goals onto the ice to start this OT against Phoenix. Canucks, with the point, move one ahead of Detroit again.
Phoenix's last overtime win was against the same Dallas team. Radim Verbata scored in overtime for the Coyotes, and that score was 2-1 also.
He's out there to start this one.
Daniel Sedin's offside. Would have been icing, but Smith out to play the puck, leaves for Roosevelt.
I just forget who, you fucking dumbass.
Here's Henrik Sedin after the puck in the corner. Daniel trying to hold it in. It's picked up and brought out by Hansel to Verbata. Check for the Vancouver line. Here comes Salo with the Sedins. Henrik's in on the right wing. Two teammates in front. Henrik to the net. Centers Daniel. Robbed by Smith. What a stop. And he keeps the game going 38 seconds into overtime.
Henrik and Daniel Sedin at the end of the shift with Sammy Salo making the play at the blue line. Turns it over. And Mike Smith reads the play very well, then gets lucky. This puck is bouncing. And Daniel can't get it up and over the goaltender. You can see Daniel's trying to get it up, but Mike Smith is right there.
Kessler comes out with Burrows as the Sedins take a rest. Hanhuis, one-timer off the draw, stopped by Smith. Hanhuis at his own blue line now. Passes over for Chris Tanev. Checked by Vermette, but able to play the puck forward to Burrows.
through center with Kessler, who takes his drop pass. Kessler wide on Yandle, around the net. Kessler up the near side, turns in the corner, tries to center, blocked by Yandle. Burrows goes after the loose puck, and Tanev moves down from the right point. Tanev behind the net to Burrows. Being tied up by a coin, but works the puck free, then falls down. Yandle moves out with it. Minute 15 gone in overtime. Yandle through center, over the Vancouver blue line. Working on hand mutes, tried a sharp angle shot. Schneider steered that away. And the puck comes outside the blue line to center. Michael Roosevelt has room. Passes ahead. Vermette makes a move trying to get around Hamhuis. Now sends the puck to the far side. After it is Ekman Larson. Dumps the puck around to the near side. Raymond was slow to react to that, and Roosevelt moves down. Passes behind the net. Vermette missed it. Bieksa after the puck. Doan is on him, and he tips it back to Dan Hamhuis, who wants off on a change. Up to Raymond. Raymond into the Phoenix zone. Passes over to Bieksa, tip pass, and a shot stopped as Aaron Rome tested Smith, and he makes another save and hangs on.
Aaron Rome was looking for some screen or for some help in front of the net, the quick pass from Kevin Bieksa, but there was nobody there. Quick passing, you can see Aaron Rome is waiting, and Yannick Hansen just can't get there fast enough.
Exactly 2 minutes elapsed in overtime, 1-1 tie. Canucks have had four shots in the overtime period already. Phoenix hasn't had any. And Aaron Rome's smile would have been even wider had that puck gone in. Daniel tried to feed Bieksa. The puck comes outside the line. Edler ahead for Henrik. Henrik's offside on this play as Smith works the puck to Adrian Acorn. Canucks are still offside, but Coyotes are able to move out. They lose the puck to Edler at the Vancouver blue line. Bieksa to Edler. Drops to Kevin Bieksa. Pulling away from Lanco. Bieksa moves over the Phoenix blue line with a wrist shot. Oh, did that catch some post? Certainly the shoulder of Smith, maybe a bit of the net as the puck goes out of play.
And you can see Mike Smith. I don't think that hit, it did hit the post. Yep. It's off the shoulder of Smith. And I think it must have caught Keith Yandle's stick the way it handcuffed him so much.
Close call for Kevin Bieksa. Now Zach Cassian comes out for an overtime shift along with Chris Higgins. Salo and Edler on the points. Coyotes get the puck. Verbata leaves for Ekman Larson. Verbata couldn't handle that pass. Edler fires over to Salo. Up the left wing, Higgins couldn't corral that one. Puck slides through to Smith. Works into the corner. Higgins intercepts, but he's checked by Roosevelt. And out with the puck is Hansel ahead to Verbata. Slowly, pass tipped away nicely by Cassian, who chips the puck forward and chases in on Verbata. He's able to poke the puck back. Canucks are going to change as the Coyotes move out. Hansel slowly through center. Waiting for help, sends the puck to the corner. Kessler goes back, Verbata's on him. Kessler able to lead for Bieksa. Ahead for Edler. Rink wide, Burrows. Oh, man. Are you going to call it?
Oh, I don't, they're calling it offside.
Player jumped onto the ice before the guy he was replacing
and
was on the bench.
You can see Alain Vigneault is hollering at the referees, and they're going to discuss this. Now here's a look, and you can see the player come on the ice before the other guy's there. And get in the way. Okay, there was no contact, but he got in the way. And you can see Newell Brown and Alain Vigneault shaking their heads. And to me, that's too many men on the ice.
90 seconds to go in overtime. And the puck hit one of the Canuck players leaning over the bench, came back on. Faceoff will be outside the Vancouver blue line as Aaron Rome was the player the puck contacted.
And now the Phoenix Coyotes want it inside the Canuck zone. They're not going to win that argument.
I think they're saying it deflected off a Phoenix stick before it hit Rome.
Well, here's Kevin Bieksa, yes.
Minute 20 to go in overtime. Whitney in, trying to back up the defense, loses the puck to Kessler. Tied up as he tries to move it out, and now it's ahead to center to Burrows. Bieksa joins him on the near side, now cuts the middle as Burrows handles the puck through the slot, tries a wrist shot. And that was blocked by Ray Whitney, who now comes up with the puck as we move into the final minute of overtime. Yandel with a burst. In on Bieksa, flips the puck to himself and then fires it off the target. Crowdy's changing as Hanhue starts out. Ahead to Kevin Bieksa, who's had an active overtime. Following up is Mason Raymond, kicks the puck to his stick, goes around the net, tries a wraparound, and Smith came across to make the save. Raymond from the corner gets the puck to Hansen. Yannick Hansen turns in the high slot, tries a shot. He was the reluctant shooter there. Couldn't get it through, and here's Korpikoski in. Cuts in front and then fired it to the corner. Alex Edler's ahead of the play, and he moves through center along with Mason Raymond. Edler in on the right side. Backhander, gloved by Smith, and he hangs on long enough to get the whistle with 10.1 seconds to go in overtime.
Mike Smith wanted to play that one. Yannick Hansen, not a bad defensive play with Korpikoski coming back. Made him cut outside inside, and Korpikoski had to shoot it wide.
Prior to that, you could tell Yannick Hansen,
he didn't want to shoot it.
He really wanted to set up the defenseman coming off the bench, but just couldn't get there in time. Face off in the Phoenix zone, Henrik Sedin against Martin Hansel. Canucks have 10 seconds to try to set up a shot at the winning goal. But the puck comes to a coin, and he shoots it around and down. And I'm not sure they'll get there in time to get another whistle. Looks like a shootout here in Phoenix as the Canucks and the Coyotes are through 65 minutes. Edler scored for Vancouver, Whitney for Phoenix, 1-1 through overtime and headed to a shootout.
This shootout brought to you by Cialis. Ask your doctor if Cialis is right for you.
Canucks with the best chance in overtime. Daniel Sedin was the man who had it, and it is our sub. There is Daniel Sedin, had the best chance in overtime. It is the Subway play of the game, brought to you by Subway Restaurants. Think fresh, eat fresh. Nice dish from Henrik. Look at Mike Smith get over and make the save. Sweet backhand saucer, even better save by the Phoenix goaltender.
14th time this season the Vancouver Canucks will be in a shootout. They're one game above 500 at 7-6, and most recently on this road trip, in fact. The Vancouver Canucks, a very memorable shootout in Detroit, John.
Well, here's Todd Bertuzzi tried to go five hole, and Alex Burrows with the backhand winner. And you can see Alex signaling the breaking of the streak, and Roberto Luongo celebrating, stopping all the shots that he faced in that shootout.
End of a 23-game home winning streak for the Detroit Red Wings. Canucks do have a shootout history with Phoenix. They're 2-2 all time, and they had one earlier this month.
Well, David Booth, what a move. Jason LaBarbera is the goalie, and Ryan Kessler. The Canucks got 4 out of 6, and then Boyd Gordon, trying to make it 4 out of 6 for the Coyotes, was stopped by Roberto Luongo. You can see he wasn't celebrating too much. He stopped half of them. And I think that's why he appreciated his performance in the Detroit shootout even more, the fact that he stopped all three.
Canucks are going to have Edler, Raymond, and Burrows as their shooters.
This is 3 of the last 4 games now the Coyotes have gone to shootouts. They beat Los Angeles 5-4 in a shootout, beat Calgary in Calgary 4-3 in a shootout.
Corey Schneider not overly happy with conditioner on his net. Now he'll scuff up the crease a little more as Ray Whitney gets sent to lead off this shootout. 3 for 5 on the season, having a sensational year outside of shootouts, but a pretty good year within as well. Corey Schneider's 1-0 this season in shootouts, stopped all three he faced in Tampa. And the Canucks have been doing a lot of this lately. Whitney starts it off, zigzagging in on Schneider. And he scores off the back bar.
Boy, Ray Whitney is so tricky. And he's a little guy, so he can pull that puck right into his body. Slaloms in and then pulls it into his body and then just snaps it right at the elbow of Corey Schneider. And it's underneath the bar, pulls it into his body, and that changes the angle enough that he can fool Corey Schneider.
Alex Edler, 3 for 6 on the season. And up against Mike Smith, whose record is 4-5 in shootouts this year. Edler trying to pull Vancouver even, and Smith stayed right with him.
And Mike Smith stayed out a little farther, and Alex Edler usually gets the goalies to back in a little farther. And you can see Mike Smith is still at the top of the net, top of the crease, when Alex lets that shot go.
Verbata trying to give Phoenix a commanding lead in the shootout. 4 for 10 on the season. From the right side, he shades in. Deeks, and oh, Schneider just held it out. Puck wound up in the corner. He wasn't sure where it was for a second.
No, off the pads and back into Verbata's skates. Radim Verbata's trying to slip it through. The goalie opens up a little bit, stays down. Off both pads, back into Verbata's skates.
Raymond trying to tie it here in round two. Haven't seen the spin move in a while.
No, we haven't.
Do you think it's time?
We've got to keep the goalies honest.
Out to the right. In towards the goal. Spins.
There it is.
And stopped by Smith, who got the left pad down.
Well, Mason Raymond comes in, tries the spin move, but Mike Smith doesn't go all the way. And you can see if the goalie doesn't go all the way across, you have to have some room, and Mason Raymond just can't get it up and over the pad.
Here's Mikhail Botker. If he scores here, Phoenix secures the extra point. Must stop for Schneider, who's up to challenge. And Botker puts it away. February ends pretty much the way the entire month went for the Coyotes. 11-0-1 for the second month of 2012.
Well, here's the play. Michael Botker fakes a shot, and you can see Corey Schneider goes for the shot. And as soon as a shooter has a goalie like that, then he's got the whole net, and Corey just can't get that stick back down.
After 26 consecutive wins for the Canucks when they led after two periods, they've had two straight blemishes. Mike Smith congratulated before heading his to the dressing room. But the Canucks now 26-0-2 on the season when they hold the 40-minute lead. Still a successful road trip. The Canucks finished 3-1-2, 8 of 12 points on the six-game excursion. They're heading home to start a seven-game homestand after losing 2-1 here in a shootout.
Canucks Hockey on Sportsnet, brought to you by Subway. Enter to win the Subway road trip of a lifetime at sportsnet.ca.
Their most difficult road trip of the season is complete. Canucks will finish the year playing 13 of 18 at home. They take 8 of 12 points, but lose the last two in extra times. This one's done, 2-1 Phoenix in a shootout.